Cambodia issues warning against unlicensed cryptocurrency trading. Authorities in Cambodia have formally warned domestic investors that they risk incurring penalties for buying, selling, or trading cryptocurrency without getting a license first. Any person or legal entity that propagates to mobilize funds, buys, sells, trades, or settles cryptocurrency without obtaining license from competent authorities shall be penalized in accordance with the applicable laws, a statement signed by the country's central bank, National Bank of Cambodia, as well as the country's police service and security regulator said. Alleged OneCoin Ponzi scheme. The authorities also warned investors that delaying cryptocurrency could result in losses owing to the volatility nature of the assets. The risk of hacking was cited as well. Additionally, the General-Commissariat of National Police, the Securities and Exchange Commission of Cambodia, and the National Bank of Cambodia warned that protection mechanisms for customers were lacking. Some of the cryptocurrency, which were singled out in the statement, when Forex Coin, Suncoin, Suncoin, Coin, and OneCoin, which has been alleged to be a Ponzi scheme. Last month, 98 people were prosecuted in China over their involvement in the alleged Ponzi scheme, with more than $267 million being recovered in the process. This came after an investigation which started in July 2016. All the jurisdictions where the Ponzi scheme revolving around the cryptocurrency created by Bulgarian national Ruja Ignatova is being investigated include Ukraine, Canada, Italy, Ireland, the United States, and the United Kingdom. This is not the first time that Cambodia authorities have issued warning over cryptocurrencies. Last year in December, the Director General of the National Bank of Cambodia, Chia Seray, agreed caution with regards to the NASCAR technology while warning that they were illegal. This thought did not prevent speculation that the country would launch a national cryptocurrency following in the footsteps of Venezuela. Not to national cryptocurrency. In March this year, for instance, reports emerged that a firm known as the Enterprise founded by Chinese businessmen would be unwilling a legal digital trend in an event where the country deputy prime minister Man Sam An would be the keynote speaker. Both the Securities Exchange Commission and the National Bank of Cambodia quickly denied the reports, saying that a state-backed cryptocurrency was not under consideration. While not the first cryptocurrency to try launching in the Southern Asia country, Enterprise was the first to claim that it had to board support of the government. Despite the harsh stance on cryptocurrency, the National Bank of Cambodia has warmly embraced blockchain technology. 2 months ago, the central bank inked a deal with Japanese firm with a view to developing a blockchain technology solution which will be used in tracking interbank transactions.